going up against the young Italian Matteo Arnaldi. That should be a very interesting matchup. Arnaldi got in when Holger Rune had to withdraw. So we'll have that for you. And we will also be bringing in the eight.
Hello to everyone. We've got players coming on court at the Next Gen Finals in Italy. What an opportunity. That was Matteo Arnaldi. World number 134. He was an alternate. He gets in. He's going to try to make the most of this chance to get to play some of the other best young talent in the game. And he will have his work cut out for him. Certainly one of the favorites in this event will be Matteo's opponent.
Signore e signori, dall'Italia, Matteo Arnaldi.
Matteo, 21 years of age. He's had a good season at the challenger level. It's got to be a pretty thrilling moment for this young man. All right, Wolf, alongside Jimmy Arias. Jimmy, we're going to get to see some fun young talent, and this guy's got to feel like this is a bonus opportunity because he got in late.
Yeah, I don't think he was expecting to be in the tournament, obviously, as the first alternate, but after Holger Rune wins in Paris and suddenly becomes top 10, he's gotten his opportunity. He's got a fairly tough matchup right out of the gate against the man we're showing you right now, and Brandon Nakashima, who's played in this event once before and won an ATP title this year. So certainly the favorite, Nakashima, in this matchup.
Yeah, Nakashima last year at this event got through the round robin stage, ended up losing to Sebi Korda in the semifinals at a good match. And there is Brandon. 21 years of age from San Diego. You mentioned the Tully one in his hometown in San Diego. Got 30 wins this season, and he will come in as the favorite. We're going to step away for a moment. When we come back, we're going to get things underway. The third match of the day in Italy. Brandon Nakashima, Matteo Arnaldi, next on Tennis Channel. Next on Tennis Channel.
Without him.
Players posing for a picture. They just did the coin toss. A couple of good-looking young men getting ready to do battle in Italy. All right, let's show you the format and some innovative new rules for this. Quicker shot clock shortened to 15 seconds after an ace, double fault, or an unreturned serve. Just one sit-down per set that takes place after the first three games. Warm-up shortened by a minute. Enhanced analytics. Players and coaches provided with an in-match data on a tablet. What do you make of this, Jimmy?
I think it's all interesting, first of all. I like the they should give you an extra minute and a half if you have a 40-shot rally, I suppose, if we're going to start doing it on the length of play. But you can see what's happened so far in the tournament. Lachecka, a straight set win. And played beautifully. 12 games, only lost 5 games. That match was a little bit closer than the score indicated. He took out Passaro, another Italian. It's funny, this is played in Italy. Italian players all over the field. They normally play clay courts. They played this next gen on fast indoor. Not really ideal for Italians.
No, but I feel like the whole theme of the event is speed, right? They're playing faster sets on a fast court. Trying to move these matches along and keep the younger generation entertained. Remember, they don't have quite the attention span we do.
The interesting thing is the warm-up also. We shorten the warm-up as you get a quick look at Arnaldi's profile, 21 years old. Well, you have to be in this tournament. He's only played once on the tour level, and that was, I believe, a Masters 1000.
It was in Rome.
He got a wild card in Rome. And has had a nice year in the challengers. And the challengers, to me, are almost the same level. They're about, you're 50 in the world to 700 in the world are almost the same. So to get through those and start winning challenger titles, that to me means you're someone that's probably ready to play at the regular tour level.
And isn't there something to the fact, look, the challenger doesn't have all the perks that the tour does. So there's a grind element to it. So, you know, if you emerge from that level to get a chance to play on tour in beautiful setups like this, there's really a reward for getting through the challengers and becoming an everyday player on the ATP Tour. And
not to mention that all of a sudden you can make some prize money, yeah. Whereas on the Challenger Tour, you're just trying to survive for the most part. Here's a look at Brandon Nakashima. And to me, you see, won a title this year in his hometown in San Diego. His record on the year, 30-23. Those are all nice, solid statistics. But I actually got got to admit, I was expecting maybe a little bit more after him breaking onto the scene last year, reaching back-to-back finals when he played in the summer last year. And he didn't really build on it. He did. Obviously, he's gone up from where he finished last year, but he didn't build on as much as I would have liked to have seen.
First meeting between these two, and just so there's no confusion, the reason Arnaldi is the number nine seed is that the draw was already set up with Holger Rune in this event. Holger Rune, after winning, decided not to play after he won in Paris on Sunday in that amazing win over Novak Djokovic. How do you forecast Brandon's chances at this event? Do you consider him one of the favorites?
I do, not just because he's one of the highest ranked, but also I feel like this sort of format where the match goes so quickly and it's you can't have any type of a letdown, as you see Nakashima's team. That's Franco Devine in the blue hat.
Well, you're talking about, you know, where is Nakashima's game? If you look at a couple of the slams, so he had some signature wins at Wimbledon, beat Denis Shapovalov. That's a high-quality win. And then at the U.S. Open, took out Grigor Dimitrov. So there's been signs that he's ready to make a big jump.
So that's where I was going with it, is saying this format where it's pressure-packed because you can't have a letdown. You can't have a nervous start or you're already down a set
right,
for the most part. So it's a type of format that I think helps someone that's so even-keeled as Nakashima is mentally. I don't think he seemingly doesn't let pressure get to him.
Well, or he's a wonderful actor because he always looks like he's the same. You can't tell if he's winning or losing.
One or the other.
All right, we are set for first ball.
Brandon Nakashima to serve. Ready. Play.
I'd be curious about the state of mind for Arnaldi. This has got to feel like a huge opportunity for him.
Yeah, of course it is, and he's playing in front of a home crowd, so he'll have the crowd loud and cheering for him. Some players struggle with that. They get nervous. They don't want to let the crowd down. Others really bring their best.
Quick love 30 star for Arnaldi. At the challenger level, a couple of signature wins this year. Beat Hugo Humbert, you know, at times has looked like a legit top 20 player. And he also beat Jill Simone in the qualies at the U.S. Open.
As I said, 50 in the world to 700. It's amazing how good they've become, that level of player. Right out of the gate, it's sort of a pressure moment for Nakashima because we were talking about the format. The other thing is it's no ad scoring, so loses any point the rest of the way in this service game, and he's facing a break point right out of the gate.
Well, he's under some serious pressure. Again, with the no ad scoring, he's now facing three break points in the opening game.
15-14.
Kind of interesting that it looks as though he's got a biggish swing on the forehand, Nakashima, and this court is quick. He's had three forehands in this game where he's a little bit late on the forehand for Arnaldi, and they got those stats going. Coach should be yelling at him, go big to the forehand, make him feel rushed to the forehand side. He had the opportunity in that point to go big to the forehand, and he chose to go into the backhand and save the price.
14. The Nakashima backhand is a tremendous weapon. It is his signature shot.
And you saw it there. It set up this forehand winner, but it was really the backhand that won the point for him. It's still a kind of set.
All right, Nakashima up a break, fifth set.
Now, that was the type of shots that Nakashima 59. Did not handle well early. Good return deep in the center. Nakashima fought off two with his forehand. Again, another great return that was paying dividends for Arnaldi early in this match. Nakashima fights them both off. Nice little run Nakashima's on, especially when you're playing to four. You get a run like this and set's almost over. An awesome return off a pretty good serve out wide. Arnaldi's backhand return down the line is incredible. I don't know if he's still moving well, Arnaldi, but he's shown some signs that his leg is bothering. Grabbed for it again just now. I don't know if slight cramp. He's feeling the nerves playing. He's not playing for so long that you would think cramp would be an issue here at this event, but he's never played with this type of intensity.
Right, I mean, how your body processes this emotional roller coaster could certainly have effect on you physically.
No question. Yeah. Most of the time for these players, if they're cramping, it's because of nerves.
Nakashima gets the hold. He is a game away from getting a win in this opening day in the round robin part of the next gen finals.
He was a game away in the fourth set as well.
We were preparing as though the match was ending.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So we'll see if there's still some fight in Matteo Arnaldi. Back up against the wall.
Well, I think Nakashima's finally figured out that the little slider serve to the forehand, that's ace, and it's setting up the rest of the points.
All right, an easy hold for Arnaldi, and Nakashima to serve for the match.
And Arnaldi asking the crowd for a little bit of help. They're hoping, he's hoping, that a little crowd noise could return or two, and maybe Nakashima will get tight again trying to serve out this match. Hume was all over the drop shot, by the way. He even had it gone over. He read it pretty well.
15-0.
Push, push with your leg.